let's get into looking at animations and transitions. To get a full scope, you can look at the FlutterFlow documentation, and it breaks down all the different types of animations that you can have in your application. Also, it breaks down if you're going to bring other effects, like Lottie or others, into your project or application. But let's go for the basics and look at just an example of an animation. Let's go back to our simple to-do task app that we created, and we're going to just navigate to the homepage, right? So if we're on a new task page, let's just go to the homepage. And once we're there, we're going to see our widget tree. We'll see our canvas that is in the middle. But then on the right-hand side, we're going to see a couple different options. Now, remember, if we're going to be looking at application, on the right-hand side, we see the properties. We see the actions. We can see the backend query. Remember when we're calling different records. And then also we see animations. So if we're going to go to a button, we might click on the new task button, and we might go over past the actions, past the backend query. We go to animations. Now there we can see on page load or on trigger mode. Right? So we're going to be able to see when the page loads, there might be animation, or we can have animation when we have a trigger, when it is pressed or something like that. So we're going to go with on trigger, and it will say add animation. Now, maybe we want it to slide, right? So right here, we can see fade, slide, scale, rotate. We can do a bunch of things. Maybe I just want it to slide a little bit. So I can click slide. And here it says, apply initial state. So here we can see duration. It's going to be 600 milliseconds. Maybe I want to bump that up to maybe 8. Okay. Go to 8. And then it says delay. I don't want to delay. And now let's go for, it will say the initial position is at 0. But maybe I want the final position. Maybe I want it like 25 or something like that, right? And I'm going to have it horizontal because here we can see horizontal slide, vertical slide. I'm just going to do horizontal. Now, once we have that, we can preview it. And you see how it moves just there. So we know that that's what's going to happen. If I don't like it, maybe I want to change a couple things. Maybe instead of 25, maybe I want it all the way to 60. And then I'm going to preview. And then it's going out further, right? So I have that. And then once I have it, I'm going to say add animation. Now, once we have that add animation, we're going to do slide. Okay, we have this right here. That's what's going to happen with the button. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my test mode. And I'm going to see what it looks like. I'm going to preview it. So I'm going to open the test mode. It's going to think about it for a moment. It's going to generate my application in test mode to try this out. And as we're waiting, remember, you can always go to the animation documentation to see all the different other types of animation, but I would really advise you to think about the purpose and what you're going to be doing with it and then going from there. So we have the test loaded. Okay, we're going to scroll down and we're going to scroll down some more. Okay, then we're going to click the test new task. Then we have this, and we'll go. Now, it already went here. Also, too, with test mode, sometimes because the delay, we might have trouble with it to see it. We're going to go into test mode again. Then we're going to see maybe it will just take time before we'll do it. Or there might be a slight delay, and we might not be able to see it in the test mode version. That might be an issue. So then we can change out the animation to when we scroll and things like that. depending on what happens. So we're going to wait until this loads in. Okay, we have this. Scroll down. We're going to tap, and we have it. So right here in the preview mode, we might have trouble with it. So let's go ahead and try something else. We're going to have the list view. And we're going to change the animation. We'll say on page load. Let's add the animation. Let's go for a slide in. Okay. I'm going to say ease in. Let's make it a little bit longer. We'll change that horizontal starting there. We'll say initial. Let's make it like 40 and then sliding in the final position. Let's take a look and preview it. So you see how it slowly came in. Let's do duration. Let's make it the initial position farther out. Let's make it like 60. Let's preview it. Okay, so we have that. Okay, let's keep it there. And let's test it. We're going to do an instant reload. And we're going to see. And again, maybe this is, we want the card, we're loading it. We'll be able to see everything slide in to the application. So once it loads, we'll see what's going on from here. And we have it. So now we see all of our cards move in, right? And we're able to do that by going to list view, remember? And then it's taking the entire list view and then they're all gonna simultaneously move in. Now, this is just one example of the different animations and transitions you can have when you're going from one page or when you're loading a page or when you're going to another. But think about what kind of transition you want and write down why. Is it a style? Is it a certain thing that you want it to do? And, you know, it's good for just the branding, but have a reason as you're going through all of these things, when you're adding animation, when you're adding all of these things, don't just haphazardly just throw an animation into your application. Think about the process of why you're going to have it. And remember, for an MVP, for the very first few applications that you're building or when you're trying to build fast, this is going to come secondarily. You want to check with your audience. You want to see why you're adding these things. It's not, for the most part, going to be imperative to add. This is going to be a nice to have. I'll see you in the next video.
That was a short clip from the complete FlutterFlow developer course inside the No-Code MBA membership area. Now, to get full access to this course and many other no-code tutorials, simply go to nocode.mba or click the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like and share this video and subscribe for more tutorials like this.